A warning, this report from Ash Nahurinag contains body cam footage of police handcuffing and restraining Kevin Clarke before his death.
You've got to breathe. Deep breath.
This is Kevin Clarke, a man who is in the midst of a mental health crisis, telling officers he is struggling to breathe.
Onto your back.
He is being restrained by two sets of handcuffs and leg restraints. Police had been called to check up on him after social workers feared for his and others' safety. Mr Clarke lost consciousness as he was taken to an ambulance. He later died in hospital. 2.5 years on, his mother, Wendy, is desperate to put on a brave face for her family.
He was a joy to be around. I missed him. I missed him so much. I cry, but I don't let the others see that I cry because I don't want to break their spirit.
Mr Clarke was living with paranoid schizophrenia. A tribute to his life is captured in this mural opposite Lewisham Police Station, the idea of former police officer Adam Pugh.
Sometimes in these cases, people just become another number or a name and a hashtag, and they don't know the story behind it. But Kevin was somebody's son, he was a brother. You know, he was, a mentor that was passionate about young people in his community.
This mural doesn't just honour a life lost. It also reflects social and racial justice issues too. The police restraint of a black man, the mental health factors too, and whether the use of force was proportionate or not. The officers involved said they'd followed correct police training procedures. Giving evidence, PC John Buckingham said leg restraints were used to protect Mr Clarke and anyone around him. And in that situation, they would automatically request such restraints.
This is a systemic issue of policing of black men in particular, but also the treatment of mental ill health as a criminal justice issue and not as a public health issue. And I think what we need to see as a result of Kevin's death is an urgent review of policing and mental health services so that we get the structural change that is needed.
Mr Clarke would have just turned 38. It is only now that his family believe they will finally be able to grieve.
He was like a father figure to us. He literally was there. He would do anything for anyone. He literally put himself before others. That's the sort of person he was. He had so many friends. He was loved. Kevin was love. Love, yeah.
Now pictures and memories are all that remain for those learning to live without him. Ash Nahurinag, Sky News.